In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a Webpack Dev Server. It will allow us to set up a development web server that will watch our project for change, and it will automatically reload our project when things change. To set up the Webpack Dev Server, I'm going to navigate to my project directory. I'm then going to install the Webpack Dev Server into dev dependencies. So I will say npm install -save -dev webpack-dev-server. Once this is installed, we can go back to our Webpack config, and we are going to add another node called dev server. We will then add a content base which will tell the server where to serve the content from, pass.join, dir name, and dist. And then we want to specify which port the server should run on. I'm going to use port 3000. I'm then going to add another property called open and set it to true. It will tell the dev server to open your default browser after the server had been started. So at this point, I will open up our package.json file. Let's add another script here called serve. And this is going to use /node/modules/.bin/webpack-serve. So let's go back over to the terminal so I can say npm run serve. You can see that the same Webpack build steps from before are being performed. And this will tell me that the project is running at localhost:3000. Now let's go back to our code to ensure that this is working as expected. We are going to open index.js and I will make a small change in our application. Let's set the text to hello from Webpack Dev Server. So when I hit save, the Webpack Dev Server will detect the change and it is going to bundle everything up again. And once the build ends up bundling, it's going to reload this for us automatically. So with the help of Webpack Dev Server, whenever we are working in a development environment, we don't have to stop and restart again. It's going to help us reload all of our assets whenever they change.